I guess Amir is here, and today we are going to discuss about the adrenal hormones. So, adrenal glands. Adrenal glands has two layers. The inner layer is the inner medulla. And outer layer is known as the adrenal cortex. Adrenal cortex. Then this adrenal cortex has further three layers. Adrenal cortex has further three layers. First one is the zona glomerulosa. Zona glomerulosa. And second is the zona fasciculata, and third layer is the zona reticularis, So this is little bit about the adrenal glands. Adrenal cortex, outer layer consists of the three layers, and inner layer is known as the inner medulla. Now we will sketch the diagram of adrenal glands in this form. The inner one is known as the adrenal inner medulla. The outer layer is the second layer, and third layer. This is the inner medulla. Okay, and first one layer, this one layer is known as the zona reticularis. Zona reticularis. And this layer is known as the zona fasciculata. Zona fasciculata. And the outermost layer is named as the zona glomerulosa. So this was little bit about the adrenal glands. So now we will discuss about adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. First we will discuss about the adrenal cortex. Adrenal cortex releases the hormones. These hormones named as the adrenocorticosteroids hormones. Hormones which are secreted by the adrenal cortex named as the adrenocorticosteroids hormones. These are three hormones which we name. First one is the mineralocorticosteroids, and second is the glucocorticosteroids. Third one are the sex hormones, and sex hormones includes two hormones, estrogen plus androgens. So hormones which are secreted by the adrenal cortex named as the adrenocorticosteroids hormones are three types of hormones. First one is the mineralocorticosteroids hormones, and second is the glucocorticosteroids hormones. Third group is the sex hormones. Sex hormones consist of two hormones, estrogen and androgens. So these are the hormones which are released by the adrenal cortex. Now we will see their production, regulation and function. First we are going to see its production. How these are produced. When we see the production of these hormones, when we say that this one hormone, mineralocorticosteroids, is produced in the zona glomerulosa. The outermost layer. And glucocorticosteroids hormone is released from this layer, because these hormones are the adrenal cortex hormones, so they will be released from the layers of adrenal cortex. The outermost layers produce the mineralocorticosteroids hormones, the middle one layer produces the glucocorticosteroids hormones, and inner one layer produces the sex hormone. So this is something about the production of these hormones, where these hormones being produced. Now we will see that how the production of these hormones takes place. This time we are discussing the adrenal cortex hormones. So there is a cholesterol. We have cholesterol in our body. This is a complete process for learning. I will write the intermediates. After that, I will write the names of the enzymes which acts on that intermediates and change them into further hormones. First, I am going to write just intermediates. For intermediates, cholesterol will be changed into pregnenolone. Further, this selection structure in the sketch will be moved further on. So I would like to write here is a formula with which we will move on. Formula is the pre-program decoration. This is the formula for learning the intermediates that we use here. So pre mean pregnenolone and pro mean progesterone. Pregnenolone will be changed into progesterone. This is the first one, progesterone, okay, progesterone, okay. Now first program, okay. Pre pregnenolone and program pro progesterone. And what does mean DE? DE mean deoxycortisterone. How I get the name with DE? Deoxycortisterone, deoxycortisterone. And further, next intermediate is the deoxy will be removed, and next is the cortisterone. Cortisterone. So it will come from the cortisterone, and next from A, aldosterone. Aldosterone. So these were the hormones or intermediates which comes here. Pregnenolone not just only give direct progesterone, but also produced another hormone named 17-hydroxypregnenolone. So here this 17-hydroxypregnenolone may be give another enzyme known as the DHEA, dihydroxyepiandrosterone. This is enzyme which is given by the 17-hydroxypregnenolone. Pregnenolone can give this hormone, but because of the reaction of different enzymes, it can also be changed into 17-hydroxy. Instead of pregnenolone, it will be changed into progesterone. 17-hydroxyprogesterone. So this one can give further two reactions. It may be changed because of the different action of the enzymes. This one may be changed into progesterone, or further it may be moved downward. How we will give downward name? That this is the deoxycortisterone. This will be the deoxycortisol. Just you will change the last name, cortisterone and cortisol. Deoxycortisol. Further, it gives the cortisterone and it will give the cortisol. So this was little bit. These are the hormones. How these hormones are produced? Cholesterol will be changed into pregnenolone. Pregnenolone will give these hormones with this formula, or pregnenolone can give the another hormone named so it can give two products, also this hormone and maybe this hormone, because of change of the enzymes. So this one also can give two products. Progesterone can give moved on, and also can give this hormone. Now I would like to write the enzymes which acts on these processes. First enzyme here, it will act the cytochrome P450. P450. When this enzyme will act on the cholesterol, then cholesterol will be changed into the pregnenolone. This is the precursor. Pregnenolone is the precursor of all steroids hormone. So this is about the pregnenolone. When enzyme known as the dehydrogenase or isomerase will act on the pregnenolone, it will change into the progesterone. So same like that, if another enzyme named 17 alpha hydroxylase act on the same hormone, same precursor, then it will change into another product, 17 hydroxypregnenolone. So this difference is because of the different enzymes. So this can be further changed into progesterone because of the same enzyme known as the dehydrogenase or maybe the isomerase. So this is, and now we will move down. What is here? Progesterone. Progesterone may be changed to deoxy. How progesterone changed to deoxycholesterone? With the help of an enzyme known as the C21 hydroxylase. Here will also act on another enzyme, hydroxylase. Same enzyme in this line, hydroxylase. Here will be also the hydroxylase. Here will also be the hydroxylase. Here also the hydroxylase. But difference is carbon number. Here is the C21, here will be the C11 beta hydroxylase, and here will be the C18 hydroxylase. But here will be the same, like this C21 hydroxylase, and here will be also the same C11 beta hydroxylase. So these enzymes will act on these hormones and they will change into different hormones. And here is the end. If 17 hydroxyprogesterone is acted by the dehydrogenase isomerase, it will change into progesterone. But another exam, C17 to C20 lyase, if this enzyme acts on this hormone 17 hydroxyprogesterone, then it will change it into the DHEA. This is another hormone. So this was the production of the adrenal cortex hormones. Which hormones? DHEA, cortisol, aldosterone, corticosterone, and these are the hormones of the adrenal cortex. So this was the production of the hormones. So now we will discuss about the functions of these hormones. We will discuss about the functions of these hormones. First, I would like to write the mineralocorticosteroids hormones. These are the hormones which are produced in the outermost layer named as the zona glomerulosa. What is the function? The function of mineralocorticosteroid, the most important mineralocorticosteroid hormone now named as the aldosterone. What is the function of mineralocorticosteroid hormone? These hormones regulate the minerals concentration in our body. This is the function of mineralocorticosteroid hormone. Let's suppose that example, which is the most important, aldosterone. This acts on the distal tubule of nephron, and it causes the reabsorption. Reabsorption of sodium ion, which is a mineral. If there is a greater production of sodium in the urine and less production of sodium in our body, then it causes the reabsorption of sodium from the distal tubule of nephron. So it causes the regulate of mineral concentration in our body. So this was the function of mineralocorticosteroids hormones. How they are being regulated? Their regulation, why they are being released? how they are regulated, why they are being released. Regulation depends upon the ACTH hormone, which is being released from the pituitary gland. It is being released from the pituitary gland, or maybe the sodium ion concentration or potassium ion concentration. When there is an imbalance of sodium ion concentration, potassium ion concentration, then hypothalamus will detect this signal from bloodstream and it will secrete the corticotropin releasing hormone, which will act on the pituitary gland to secrete the adrenocorticotropin releasing hormone, which will cause the release of the mineralocorticosteroids hormone. So second hormone is the glucocorticosteroids hormone. What is the function of glucocorticosteroids hormone? What is the function of glucocorticosteroids hormone? The first function is they causes the production of carbohydrates. So carbohydrates metabolism says that they increase the production of carbohydrates. But how they increase the carbohydrate production? They work against the insulin. So they increase the glucose level. They cause the formation of glucose. Because they cause the formation of glucose, glucose is a carbohydrate. So they increase the production of carbohydrates. Second is the protein metabolism. What happens in protein metabolism? In protein metabolism, it acts as both anabolic and catabolic. What happens in anabolic? In anabolic, these cause transcription and translation. So through these processes, they cause the production of proteins. Proteins are being formed, so this process will be named as the anabolic. But in case of catabolic, they cause also denaturation of proteins. Denaturation of proteins named the catabolic reaction. So they act on protein metabolism in two ways. First is the anabolic, second is the catabolic. In case of anabolic, it will cause the transcription and translation and protein production. But in case of catabolic, they will cause the denaturation of proteins. Third, its action on the lipids. They will cause the lipolysis. What means lipolysis? Lipolysis means they will cause the breakdown. Breakdown of triglycerides, which are present in the adipose tissue. And they will change the triglycerides into the free fatty acids. So this was the third function of the glucocorticosteroids hormone, named as the lipolysis. Lipolysis is the breakdown of triglycerides, adipose tissues. Triglycerides are present in the adipose tissues into the free fatty acids. So this was the function of glucocorticosteroids hormone. Third hormone named as the sex hormones, which are the estrogen and androgens. We will discuss sex hormones in the gonadal hormones separately in the next tutorial. But now I would like to explain about the adrenal medulla hormones. Because the inner layer of the adrenal glands is the adrenal medulla. We have just discussed about the outer layer named the adrenal cortex. But now we have to discuss adrenal medulla. Adrenal medulla releases the hormone named as the catecholamines. Adrenal medulla secretes hormones named as the catecholamines. Catecholamines consist of three hormones, basically two hormones. First one is the epinephrine, and second is the norepinephrine. The second name of epinephrine is adrenaline. And what is the second name of norepinephrine? Is the noradrenaline. So we will say that adrenal medulla secretes the hormone named as the catecholamines. Catecholamines consist of basically two hormones, epinephrine and norepinephrine. And epinephrine second name is the adrenaline, and second name of the norepinephrine is the noradrenaline. But there is also an intermediate hormone which is also included in the catecholamines. That hormone named as the dopamine. So these are the hormones which are released by the adrenal medulla, the inner layer of the adrenal glands. So now we will discuss the production and function of the adrenal medulla hormones, the function and production of the catecholamines hormones. So first we will discuss about the production, how they are being produced. Here is the precursor, tyrosine. Precursor is the tyrosine is an amino acid which acts as the precursor. Tyrosine will be changed into DOPA, named as the dihydrophenylalanine. So this is the product of tyrosine, because some enzymes absorb the tyrosine. I will write the enzymes later. So dopamine will be changed into dopamine. Then this dopamine will be changed into norepinephrine. Norepinephrine will be changed into epinephrine. And different enzymes will act on the different processes. The enzyme will act here named as the tyrosine hydroxylase. When tyrosine hydroxylase enzyme will act on the tyrosine, which is the precursor, of adrenal medullar hormones, it will act on the tyrosine. Then tyrosine will be changed into DOPA. Then another enzyme named as the decarboxylase. When this enzyme will act on the DOPA, then DOPA will be changed into dopamine. Dopamine is the intermediate hormone of the which is included in the catecholamines and released from the adrenal medulla. Another enzyme named as the dopamine beta hydroxylase will act on the dopamine. Dopamine will be changed in the norepinephrine, which is the also hormones of adrenal medulla and included in the catecholamines. So this hormone production has been completed. Now norepinephrine will be changed into epinephrine hormone through the transferase, through an enzyme named as the transferase. When transferase enzyme will act on the norepinephrine, then it will be changed into epinephrine. So now we are going to the last part of our tutorial, is that the function of these catecholamines. Basically, these hormones act together for the production of for their function. They act together. Suppose that the hormones are the which hormones? Epinephrine and norepinephrine. These are the two hormones These both hormones cause the increased production of glucose. Increased production of glucose. So they increase the glucose level in blood. They increase the glucose level in blood and they work the against insulin. And they work the against insulin. They work against the insulin. This is the first function of the epinephrine. And norepinephrine, what function? Epinephrine and norepinephrine causes the more production of the glucose level. So they increase the glucose level in the blood and work against the insulin. Second function, this was about the carbohydrates. Now we will also discuss about the lipid metabolism. What they do with the lipid? So now we will discuss about the lipid metabolism. In lipid metabolism, they cause the lipolysis. What happens in lipolysis? What is lipolysis? I have just explained earlier in this tutorial that lipolysis is the breakdown, is the breakdown of triglycerides. Which triglycerides? Which are present in the adipose tissues, So the triglycerides which are present in the adipose tissues will be break down into free fatty acids. What does mean free fatty acid? These are also the monomers of the triglycerides, but are free. Free mean they are in the circulatory system. They are in the circulation, moving freely. So this was the second function of the lipids, epinephrine and norepinephrine. Now I am going to discuss the last thing, which is the sympathetic, which is its effect on the sympathetic system. This is the most important function. It's function that the epinephrine and norepinephrine also act as the, neurotransmitters of the sympathetic nervous system. What is the sympathetic system? These neurotransmitters cause the contraction of the different muscles and glands. So the function of sympathetic nervous system is the activation of in the sympathetic nervous system. The cardiac input increases. So they cause the cardiac output increases. Also the blood pressure increases. Because these are the neurotransmitter of sympathetic nervous system. And what is the sympathetic nervous system? In sympathetic nervous system, cardiac output increases and blood pressure also increases. So these hormones also act as a neurotransmitter in sympathetic nervous system and act as a contractors, so they cause the increase of cardiac output and blood pressure. Now I am going to review the functions of the adrenal medulla. First one is the epinephrine and norepinephrine cause the glucose blood level increases in our blood and it causes the it function against the insulin. Second is the lipid metabolism, lipolysis. What happens in lipolysis? Lipolysis is the breakdown of triglycerides in adipose tissues, which then change into free fatty acids, which are circulates in the circulatory system. And third, the last one, the sympathetic system. This acts as a neurotransmitter. Sympathetic system, so cause the increase of cardiac output and blood pressure. So this was about the adrenal cortical hormones. So thank you so much, guys.
कौन फजूल लोग थे जो आए अभी तुम्हें पता है वो दिन हाथ यूं करके गए वीडियो के